The list is almost endless, and there is a shrine in Japan where more than 2 million kami are registered. Sometimes it is said that there would be more than 8 million different kami. It is not exactly that. There is a general name given to these countless kami, Yaoyorozu no kami, which means literally 8 million. But what it expresses is countless, extremely numerous. People don't actually believe that there are precisely 8 million, but that there are many, many of them. Generally, there are considered to be three main variations of kami. There are the heavenly gods and goddesses, called Amatsu kami, the gods and goddesses of the earthly realm, Kumitsu kami, and the rest, the countless kami. These definitions are broad categories, sorts of guidelines for grouping them. The worship of kami through rituals and offerings is at the core of Shinto practice. The kami are worshipped at household or family shrines and at public shrines dedicated to specific kami. The worshipping, the rituals, are done to cultivate harmony between kami and humans and to ask for kami's blessing. The kami are not particularly good or bad, malevolent or benevolent. They may have both dimensions, and they are never fully reliable. So securing their support is believed to be important for luck and success in all sorts of endeavors. Shinto comes with principles such as the need to respect traditions and regularly perform rituals of purification, but it does not emphasize specific moral codes. There is no equivalent to the commandments of Christianity, and Shinto doesn't have a centralized organization like the Catholic Church or some Protestant denominations. It is historically the most widespread religious practice in Japan, but not the only one. Buddhism also was and still is important. So how did religions spread in Japan?